actually get pockets of molten material, and then you hit it, and it just, blah. Anybody who's ever made the mistake of picking up a piece of what they thought was steel, and it was actually some form of cast iron, you heat it up, you hit it a few times, a nice red heat, seems like it's okay, you heat it, you hit it a couple more times, and it just crumbles into nothing on the anvil. That's about as hot as I want to get this stuff.
Thank you.
particularly highly developed in Toledo is the laminated steel, where you would start with, you wouldn't necessarily be doing what would be referred to as pattern welding. You're not trying to develop a pattern, but instead you're taking wrought iron, essentially folding it back on itself many, many times to remove as many impurities as you can. Essentially, the aim was always to develop a material that was as homogeneous as possible, as uniform as possible. And the person who eventually brought crucible steel to Europe was a man who wanted to make watch springs and clock springs. And they needed, in order to be accurate, you needed to have as much uniformity from one to the next as possible. And it's very difficult to achieve that when you're starting with an impure material and laminating it, you know, and trying to control the carbon content through essentially a forging process. It doesn't work out well. There are going to be slight differences between them, but within an ingot, they're going to be essentially the same. And when they started doing the crucible process in Europe, it was on an industrial scale. They were using crucibles about this tall, this big around. And they would take the best steel that they had and load it up with that and just remelt it. Off the side. and that is the result of the impurities in that end of the bar. Why this end of the bar is going to get used.
Like this, you can get away with a lot more temperature variation.